2022 season, and there's no love lost between these AFC South foes. It's the Colts and the Texans, and it's coming right up on Madden NFL 23. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Today we jump right into this new season with an AFC South matchup between the Indianapolis Colts and the Houston Texans.
Put the preseason behind him and begin this 2022 campaign. And one of the folks we'll be watching is this. On play action, Mills. They'll get this into the hands of Nico Collins. They work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards, the final tally.
Probably that's the start that you are right there. And you know, he spent the entire offseason throwing hundreds, I'd probably say thousands of passes, getting ready for that moment. The first throw of the new season. He's dreamed about it, thought about it, and now it's out of the way.
Now, one for one, a lot more to go. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. They'll keep it on the ground. Traylor, and the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. So the new man in the backfield getting his first touches of the regular season here. Limited production and opportunity in his first 4 years in the league, but he's getting the shot now as the lead back for this offense. CD, what do you think he brings to the table?
Well, I think he's a pretty well-rounded back, and we know he's extremely motivated because we talked to him this week. He made it crystal clear that he's been waiting for this moment. He's at the top of the depth chart, and he's got a chance to really shine in this role as well as produce.
Here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver. And only able to get 2 here, stopped at the 30. And for the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on 3rd down. Now a handoff up the middle. Traylor. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. He needed 3, he got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on 4th and a yard.
When a good play is made on defense, oftentimes leverage is the key to everything. Defensive line not getting turned, all the other guys making sure they're in the right spot. And on that play, they were able to stop him short of a 1st down.
Now after the play, it looks like there's a Texan here slow to get up. And on about how his experience backing up Derrick Henry the last 4 years really put him in the position he's in now as the starter.
Well, that makes sense because for 4 years, he was in the room with arguably the best running back in the league. And the one thing he said he took from his time backing up Henry was that he noticed a gap. With his knowledge and experience, I think he could move up quickly over the next few years.
To throw again on second down, Mills. And Cooks hands it over the middle. And brought down, but not before they get inside the 10 to the 7. First catch of the new season for him, and it picks up the first.
This game reaches a point to get down the field. It's taking a long time to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
Gate a third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Over the middle here to Rudolph. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. Able to convert on third and 14. A terrific play call.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw. And they hooked up there for a first down.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10.
The steamroller, baby!
Your game to win. Now a handoff up the middle. Traylor. And able to get him inside the 5 here, just inside the 5. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. They'll keep it on the ground. Traylor. And he fights his way into the end zone for a Texans touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Texans are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, as one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now, starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Throw it. Mills. He's got his man. It's the tight end, Brevin Jordan. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. The catch and run pays off for 29 yards.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, Parker. And watch him drive. And it would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you have both now. This is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Mills now looks to throw on first down. That's complete. It's Collins. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line.
Timing is so important on a route like this because he's going to line up out right then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield.
Throwing again on 2nd down, but this time it's incomplete.
See, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
That fourth quarter, maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. On 3rd down, Traylor. He finds some open field here. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. A great effort there. 35 yards. And the Texans have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. So they went to the ground game on 3rd, hoping to pick up the first. They also picked up a touchdown.
Offensive linemen so used in this situation to having a pass block. Right? You're looking at what it is, 3rd down. They don't care that it's 3rd and whatever. They figure they're going to throw the ball. And when you call a running play, I think you energize it. I think you juice them up, because I haven't met offensive linemen yet that likes to pass block more than they like to run block. And they opened up some nice holes there for him, and he took it to the house.
This was a division game here in week one, and to come forward a 1-0 start against a division opponent gives you a little something extra heading forward for the rest of the season.
Yeah, let's pile it all into one game, right? Opening the season, and you open within the division. You knew the motivation was going to be there on both sidelines. One just executed better and earned the win.
So for the Texans, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week one victory here by a field goal. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Denver Broncos. Meanwhile, for Indianapolis, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll be on the road next week as they get a date with the Jaguars in Jacksonville.